Uh-oh, that's not gonna be good. Let's go find it. Going to be good. I've hit my ball into an unplayable lie, and I can go to the rules of golf and find out what are my options. My first option is I can hit that ball, but I don't want to hurt my club. It's in a hazard, so I've got to find the closest place of relief and incur a stroke penalty. That's what the rules of golf say. You know, I would never consider, because I love golf, I would never consider saying, well, I don't like that rule, and so I'm going to tear it out of the rule book. I don't want to play by that rule. Well, pretty soon I wouldn't have many golfers to play with, because no one wants to play with someone that breaks the rule. So I'm going to find my place of relief, I'm going to take my punishment, I'm going to add a stroke, and I'm going to play. You know, the Bible is our rule book for life. Tells us what's right, tells us what's not right, tells us how to get right, and it tells us how to stay right. You know, it's sad that we sometimes take the rules of golf, and if we don't like it because it affects us, we just think we can tear that out. You know, for example, the Word of God talks about forgiving, that we must forgive others because God has forgiven us. And the Bible says that if I don't forgive you of your sins, God won't forgive me of my sins. I don't want to throw that out because I want my sins forgiven. So I'm not going to take that out because it's hard for me. Or when it says to love your enemy. You know, a lot of people, well, it's in the Bible, but I don't believe the Bible. Well, it's in the Bible. We need to take seriously the things of God. I'm going to continue playing golf. I'm going to continue playing by the rules. And I'm going to continue to walk in life and playing by the rules that God has set for you and I. And I promise you, if you'll play by the rules, you'll have a better round of golf and you'll have a better life. The first thing we do is we confer with it. You know, we confer with ourselves, or we confer with what we think about the matter. What would happen though if we prayed about it? You know, a lot of times we make a lot of decisions and we've not even invited God into our situations.